Welcome back to Spell and Math Tutorials. It's me, AJ. Today we continue our Valentine's Day series with tutorial number 3. This will be the last video in this series. In a moment, we're going to explore the heart equation that you see here in red, and we're going to do that using the online graphing tool Desmos. And by the end of this clip, you'll be able to create a dynamic project. And also, please let me know what you think about this project in the comments below. Let's begin by taking a look at the finished project. Here we have 4 hearts of different colors. Those hearts move away from each other, and we can control the speed and the distance at which they move away from each other. And then the hearts reverse direction and come towards each other. Again, we can control that speed. Eventually, these hearts all overlap, making it look like a single heart. And we see that there. Now let's go ahead and first take a look at this analytically, and then we'll begin actually building the project. All right, let's begin by showing that the hearts are going to move on these blue line tracks diagonal. We're going to set these values here to be, or this angle here, we're going to set that to start off to be pi over 4. And as we count around the unit circle, again, I'm going to place a video up here so you can take a look at that tutorial to better explain that or explain it more in depth. We have pi over 4. This is 2 pi over 4. This here would be 3 pi over 4. Down here would be 5 pi over 4. Over here would be 7 pi over 4. We're going to use these radian measures and what we know about trig to help us figure out what the coordinates are for each one of these points. And just dealing with the point here in the first quadrant, for the x value is going to be the radius, or this distance, and I'm going to call it t because Desmos likes to use r for a different purpose. So we're going to say the length, or the value t, times cosine, in this case the radian measure, pi over 4, and then the y value is going to be t times sine, and again pi over 4, and that there would be the there's going to be the y value. Now as we go around the unit circle, we're going to replace the pi over 4 with 3 pi over 4, with 5 pi over 4, and then 7 pi over 4. So let's go ahead and let's begin to actually build this project. So let's go here to the hamburger menu. Let's go down here to our clean slate. All right, the first thing I want to do is place in the heart equation. So here that equation is x raised to the second power. And then we're going to add a quantity, and that quantity is going to be y minus. And in a previous video, I used x raised to the 2/3. But after reading some documentation, I found that I can actually put the heart equation in as it is written here, showing the cube root of x to the second power. Well, to do that, there is a command called nth root. So type in nthroot. And now we can actually place in the index for the radical. In this case, the index is 3. And then we can place in the value under the radical, or expression under the radical, which is x raised to the second power. And then that entire quantity is squared. And then we can set that x to the inequality, make that less than or equal to 1. And then notice here we have the heart. In a previous tutorial that I did in the heart series, I actually created a second equation. Let's go ahead and do that. So let's copy that, and then let's paste it, and then let's change the size of the heart. And now we see that we have 2 hearts in here. But I found that in Desmos, I can use some functionality called a list. And with the list, I can actually feed in multiple values. So what I'm going to do here is use a list for the size of the heart. And that list uses square brackets. And I'm going to place a 1 and a 2. So now one of the hearts is going to have the size where 1, and the other one's going to have a size that corresponds to the 2. So now I can get rid of the second equation and notice that I still have the 2 hearts here. Now what I want to do is, again, let me flip back. What I want to do here is I want to place in the transformations for the x values and for the y values. We're going to begin with pi over 4. So let's go ahead and put that in place. And then we're going to also create this slider t that allows us to say how far the heart is going to move from the origin of the coordinate plane. So here, let's place this this transformation on the x value. So let's place in minus, and we're going to use t cosine, and we're going to use pi over 4. And then let's place in the parenthesis, and let's copy this so that we can move a little bit faster. So let's go ahead and place that transformation over this x that we see underneath the radical. Again, place in some parentheses, and let's paste that in. And then let's go and let's put in the transformation for the y value, and that's going to be minus, in this case, t sine. And again, we want to use the pi divided by 4. And let's go ahead and let's add the slider. And what we see here is now we see the two hearts, and we see as I move the slider, we see the hearts move. As a matter of fact, let's change it so everything stays positive. Let's make this go from 0 and let's say up to 5, moving in increments of a tenth. And now we're at 0, which puts us there at the origin. Now as I begin to move t, which is like the radius, we see the heart begins to move out. Let's zoom out some so we can see a little bit better. All right, and we see that it's going to move in that direction. When I move back, it comes back. Now let's go ahead and let's copy this. So Control A to copy. Control A to select everything, Control C to copy. Let's press Enter to get a second line, Control V to paste, and let's just move this out so we can see this a little bit better. And remember, we chose 3 power over 4 for the next radian measure. So here, let's change this to 3 power over 4, 3 power over 4, and 3 power over 4. And then we have a second heart there, but let's change this radius so that they move apart and move away from each other. So there are those two. And since I already have the equation copied on the clipboard, let's paste it in, press Enter, and paste it in again and press Enter. The next one is going to be 5 power over 4. Let's place in these 5s. And the last one down here is going to be 7 power over 4. So let's place in these 7s. And let's change the color. I don't want black for this one. Let's go ahead and make it, let's make that one orange. So now we see we have the four hearts there. And let's click the play button here. And we should see those hearts move away from each other and then towards each other. Let me change the speed a little bit. So let's make this, let's slow it down a bit to 0.35. We see them moving away and then towards each other. Let's go ahead and zoom in. Let's go ahead and get rid of that there. Let's get rid of the axes and the grid. All right, and here we have the completed project. Here we see the hearts are moving back towards each other. As they come together, they should all overlap to create a single heart. Let's wait a moment to see that. All right, there's that overlap, and then they go back in the opposite direction. All right, this sums up the tutorial. Please let me know if you found this to be a fun project. Also, let me know if you've made some type of alteration to the project to make it your own. That will sum up this tutorial. Thanks for watching, and as always, have a great day and have a great Valentine's Day.